Tell me, ma, when I go home, the boys don't leave the girls alone to pull my...
Should we open our presents first?
What presents?
The feckin' Christmas presents.
We agreed not to buy any presents this year, remember?
Ah, for Jesus' sake. That's just something people say. It doesn't mean anything.
Well, it's too late now.
We've no money anyway.
Yes, that breaking me heart. Just know that if the baby Jesus only knew how he's are treating your own mother on Christmas Day.
Happy Christmas, everyone. Where's your kids, Dimfna?
They're up at the church getting their presents from the Vincent de Paul. They love it every year.
Ah, that's wonderful. Here you are, Emphysema, my love. This is for you. Happy Christmas.
Finally, a Christmas present. Thank you, Jimmy.
Children, I'm going to give you each a free tattoo. You can pick one out of me tattoo book. Here, I made you these coupons.
Thanks all the same, Jimmy, but I'm grand.
I haven't had a tetanus shot recently, so I'll hold off on a tattoo this year.
Well, maybe for the birthday, so. These coupons are good for a year. Now, Fasima, are you not going to open your present?
I was just enjoying the moment, you know, before I open it, like.
Before the disappointment, like?
At least someone cared enough about me to buy me a present.
I made that present for you.
You made it?
With me own hands.
You know, I don't like presents that people make. I like presents that you buy in a shop, like.
You're going to love it, Emphysema.
No, I'm not going to love it, Jimmy Balls.
Open it, darling, will you?
Okay. What the feck is this?
It's a hot water bottle. Well, tube, really. I made it from a bicycle tyre. You fill it with hot water.
It's a peculiar shape, isn't it?
It's for the toilet, see. You sit on it. You're always giving out about how cold the toilet seat is. Now, you never have to worry about that again.
I'm supposed to sit on this? Is that what you mean?
It'll be a nice warm cushion between you and the toilet seat. You never want to get off it now.
It's so romantic.
I think so. I tried it earlier. Works great.
You had your arse on this?
I had to test it, love.
Here, so. Put it on the feckin' toilet while I put the turkey in the feckin' oven. Happy feckin' Christmas.
I love Christmas. Is it going to snow, I wonder?
It's going to rain.
I hope my kids don't get too wet.
That dinner was lovely, Emphysema, wasn't it, Jimmy?
I have to say, that turkey was only delicious, Emphysema. I think we did a good job putting it away.
We'll save the bones for the soup tomorrow.
There's not a scrap of meat on those bones, thanks to Jimmy Balls.
Be nice to Jimmy, Norman. He can't help being as big as he is.
Oh, I think he can, actually.
Okay, so we've had our dinner. We had a little drink. The kids are out.
Sure, they never came back.
I told them to take their time. So, Jeremy, I think you owe us all a little story about why you were in prison.
Don't pressure him, Dimfna. Will we have some Christmas cake for us? It looks lovely.
That cake is from last year.
Those cakes last forever, Norman. Now shut up.
They last forever because no one wants to eat them.
Forget the feckin' cake. So, Jeremy, what did you do to be in prison for so long?
Well, I'm a little nervous.
Don't be nervous now. It's not like you murdered someone or anything like that. Now, is it?
Well, actually...
Actually what?
I did, Emphysema.
You did what?
You murdered someone?
Jimmy Balls, you brought a murderer into our home?
Would you just wait a minute?
Sure, we don't even know who we murdered, yeah?
Exactly, Dimna.
Probably some right old fecker that deserved murdering.
Probably asking for it, they were.
We're probably all better off, thanks to Jeremy.
Yeah. Thanks very much for murdering the fecker.
Who was it, Jeremy?
Who did you have to murder?
Me own mammy.
Excuse me?
Your mammy?
Wait a minute. You're telling me you murdered your own mammy?
I told her I didn't want onions in me potatoes. I told her time and time again, no onions in me potatoes, please, mammy. But she wouldn't listen.
I see. So you murdered her.
Now, I love me mashed potatoes with plenty of butter and milk, and she knew that. She knew it very well.
Of course she did.
So she goes and puts a finely chopped raw onion in them every single time. And I'd have to pick them out with me fork.
You poor fecker, you.
By the time I picked them all out, me potatoes would be stone cold. Dinner was a nightmare for me. There was only the two of us.
You and your mammy.
Where was your daddy?
Me mammy was never quite sure who me daddy was. He drank in the county bar, that's all she knew.
Ah, shall we all make those mistakes?
Some more than others.
How did you kill her, Jeremy, if you don't mind me asking?
Don't tell them. I don't want them getting any ideas.
Tell them, Jeremy. Let's get it all out in the open. No more secrets.
Except for the other thing, of course.
Let's not mention the other thing right now, Jeremy. Please.
Wait, there's another thing?
Well, never mind the other thing. How did you murder your mammy in the end?
She was standing over my shoulder.
Oh, I hate that.
She was ordering me to eat dinner.
And you just couldn't take it anymore, is that what it was?
Exactly, Norman. I couldn't take it anymore.
I know the feeling.
How did you do it?
I stuck me fork into the back of her head. She didn't even notice it at first. She went to the other end of the table, sat down, took a sip from her baby sham and collapsed into her mashed potatoes and died.
Just died?
And what did you do?
Well, I finished me potatoes because I was after picking all the onions out anyway. I had a cup of tea with some custard cream biscuits.
I love them.
I watched the telly for a bit.
What was on?
Father Ted.
Lovely.
Did you ring the police?
As soon as Father Ted was over, I rang them, yeah. And here I am now, 15 years later.
Well, now, I'm glad that's out of the way. Let's just put that behind us.
I think you'll be eating your dinner with a spoon from now on, Jeremy. Is that okay with you?
Ah, whatever makes you happy, emphysema.
I'll let him use a fork. What's the worst that can happen? Jeremy, do you have a minute? Can I come in?
Of course, Norman.
I'd like for us to be friends, Jeremy.
Ah, that'd be lovely, Norman.
Tell us, were you always wanting to kill your mammy?
Deep down, I think so, Norman, yeah.
And did you feel better once you did it?
Oh, I felt great. It was like a weight had been lifted from me.
I can only imagine.
Of course, when the police came, I began to think, maybe I made a mistake.
Well, you seem fine now, though.
I'm grand now, yeah.
If you had your life to live over, would you do it again?
Kill me mammy, you mean?
Yeah, kill me mammy. I mean your mammy.
Well, if she kept doing that to me mashed potatoes, yeah. I would kill her again.
I see. Thanks, Jeremy. It's been nice chatting with you. I always wanted to be an orphan. Did you know that? Anyway, happy Christmas.
This Christmas cake is only delicious, Dimfna. And I don't mind using a spoon.
We'll never be allowed to use forks again.
All we ever used in prison were spoons anyway.
Jeremy must really, really, really hate onions.
Is me mammy in here?
Are you all right, Norms? You don't look well.
I'm grand, Jimmy Balls.
Jimmy's right. You look very strange, Norms.
I just need to see me mammy.
Well, she's upstairs, son.
Thanks, Daddy.
Jesus, that was very strange. What's got into him, I wonder?
Did he just call me Daddy? Oh, it really is Christmas, Dimfna.
Definitely not himself at all. Holy feck, that's Mammy.
Sounds like she's being murdered.
Feckin' Jeremy.
I'm coming, darling. I hope we're not too late to save her.